inch pizza together, me and Deep Brad. Some people question why we're doing it. Some people think we're just doing it just for the money. We're just in there for the gold. But I think it's for the honor. Originally, my plan entitled using Depends in case I had to, you know, wet myself or relieve myself otherwise. But now they're letting us go to the bathroom, so this shouldn't be that.
I also thought about using Depends, but they're going to let us go to the bathroom, which I think is foolish, so it won't come to that. I've never forced myself to throw up, but if I have to for my share of the loot, I'll do it. And just, you know, to be the only ones. My only concern is after we do it, they'll bar us from competing again.
I am extremely confident because I don't think there's any possible way that we can actually lose.
And I don't think it'll take us a full hour either. Maybe 40 minutes, but, you know, if we need the hour, we'll use it. I was a little worried last night. I went to this Mexican restaurant and then to Wendy's. And I tried to go to Dairy Queen, but they were closed. But this morning I woke up and I was actually kind of hungry. And then I drank a gallon of water, stretched out my stomach. So I don't think it'll be an issue. And I haven't really been training over the last couple weeks, but I've been trying to eat more than I usually do. You know, just stretch myself out.
I think they got it. I think it might be kind of torturous to watch, but I think they got it. I've seen Andy in some eating competitions. Well, I saw him in a hot dog competition, and Andy's a vegetarian for the most part, so that was pretty impressive. And the guy that won cheated. He spit out half a hot dog, so that doesn't count. Andy should have won.
Yeah, so I went to like a CeCe's Pizza and had like 22 slices of pizza and like 11 cinnamon rolls.
And CeCe's Pizza isn't the best pizza either.
It's not, and it's not thin crust. But you know what I'm actually thinking about? Since we're in the glorious town of Springfield that does have a CeCe's Pizza, if I went $250 here, I think I might make a trip to the all-you-can-eat pizza buffet right after this, just to prove my dominance.
I actually also went to a CeCe's one time with Tom and some other people, and I ended up eating over 27. I think it was like 27 and a half, and I had, or maybe 27 and some pasta. But I had a lot of pizza there. And then also one time, two summers ago, I was over on the East Coast and I was in New Jersey. I went with my brother-in-law to some burger place. I'm not sure what it was called, I can't remember, but they had this 3-pound burger called the Belly Buster. Well, I got a double Belly Buster, and so I ate that. I mean, it was a huge burger, as big as the plate.
Was it 6 pounds?
It was 6 pounds. I ate that and an order of the jalapeno poppers, and I had 2 strawberry milks. And I felt pretty uncomfortable afterwards, but I ate it, and I was pretty proud about that.
So this is gonna be in us, plus some other things.
Yeah.
We're just gonna put it in. Okay. Cool.
All right. Well, here's how it's gonna go. I make this thing in like 3 different steps.
Okay.
Step 1 is I have to crust it. I roll it out and crust it, right? And I'm gonna show it to you guys because rolled out of the pan, it gets thicker once it rises.
Okay.
So I show you the crust, give you a chance to back out. And then after that, I'm gonna make it, put everything on it before I put it in the oven. No turning back. You know, I show it to you again with everything on it.
Okay.
Okay. So you guys still have a chance. I can take it apart still. After it goes in the oven, I can't take it apart. You guys gotta pay for it.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. And that's how it's gonna go. So I'll start rolling it out right now.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah. I'd love to see somebody actually eat this thing.
How long have you guys been doing the contest?
Huh?
How long have you been doing the contest?
It's been open since April.
How many people have tried to do it?
Probably 10 groups. 10 groups of 2.
Who's the closest?
These guys that weighed like 400 pounds and they were like Department of Corrections guys. So they got about half.
It's thicker on the edge than in the middle, so that's good.
Yeah.
They've also had green peppers in case you'd rather do that instead of black olives.
Oh, I'd totally do green peppers over black olives.
Well, they have diced tomatoes.
They've
That's probably a good idea.
Yeah, we should probably...
Because, I mean, we're just eating marinara sauce anyway.
We're going to do green peppers instead of the black olives, though, now.
You guys get green pepper and...
diced tomatoes.
Green pepper and diced tomatoes.
Make it Christmassy.
Yeah.
They're tossing our vegetables on there. They're trying to intimidate us by chopping extra hard. But we're not scared. The harder they chop, the more delicious it'll be.
Think about expanding and making tracks. And then
yes.
Watch it really good, bud. You know, when you make a pizza, the Sicilian guy that told me, that trained me, said it gotta be whatever's on the pizza, you have to have it in every bite. I think if I do that to these guys, I don't think it'd be very fair. So I'm gonna say this pizza is almost fit for competition standards.
Move down, come on. All right, no, sit down, come on.
There it is.
We're gonna try to eat a 40-inch pizza. Do any of you guys think we can do it? We're gonna
see if
you
want.
You think we can?
I think you can.
No way.
Eat as fast as possibly can, because then you can pack it down more.
Pack it down more?
You can pack down more, expand your stomach,
the gravity.
Don't drink anything with it, because then it'll make you feel fuller faster.
I'd have to say eat fast. If you eat slow, your body.
Yeah. Oh my god.
And then they keep putting more crap on it.
Like, stack like 3 pieces at a time and just eat them.
I'm actually gonna fold mine. That's a good idea. Plus,
fold
then your hands are just on the crust and not actually on the greasy pizza.
Damn. Oh, I felt the snaps.
Start.
Oh yeah, can you explain the exact rules of everything?